Hey everyone, PPC's Matt here. So today I just wanted to give you guys a quick kind of rundown on how I set up my fans and pumps, as well as the curves for both of those. Just in general, I was going to give you guys a few tips to start out. If you're using PWM equipment like pumps and fans, it's really easy to just use like a splitter for the fans on your radiators, you know, in a water cooling loop. If you have an air-cooled system, I guess I would just group your fans on the splitters as far as each area of the case goes. Like if you have some in the top and the front, you know, split those up. Same goes for radiators. You know, split your top and your front rad up or wherever they may be. And it really kind of makes setting up curves for positive pressure and all that jazz a lot easier. So just my kind of bit of advice, if you happen to have DC-controlled fans, then you could set each of your sets of DC fans onto its own hub. In the case of a DC fan, you should obviously use a hub because you'll need the supplemental power. So beyond that, you can also, you know, use Vario pumps if you don't want to mess around with a PWM pump, which I completely understand. Varios and PWMs, it's a trade-off. It is kind of what you prefer, either if you want to set it and forget it, or if you want to set up a PWM curve for your pump like I've done and I can show you today. Beyond that, though, once you've got it all hooked up in your system, I've always just kind of resorted to the BIOS to control my fan speeds and set up curves, as most BIOSes do offer plenty of features for that, as well as it seems to be the most reliable. Unless you reset your BIOS, you're going to keep your fan curves, no matter what happens to your OS or whatever. So software is definitely very useful, and there's plenty of features that come with it usually. So if you do find that you prefer that, definitely use that, and maybe you can apply some of the tips I'm going to give you guys today to your systems. But if you guys have any questions about your particular system and how to set it up, I'd be happy to answer those in the comments, or stop by our Facebook group or our Discord. All these are right below, and I'll have them linked in the description of the video. So please stop by and ask questions. But other than that, we're going to head into my BIOS. Like I said, that's where I control everything. So I got a camera set up over here, and we're going to just kind of cover how I've set up my curves as far as that goes. So I'll catch you guys in a second. All right, so we're in our BIOS now, and I hope you guys can see it pretty well with the camera and hear me. It's a little bit of a weird angle to work with. But when I start out, I'm just in this tab in my BIOS. But for ASUS boards, and I believe ASRock, are pretty similar. But anyways, your board will definitely vary. I go to the monitor tab, and then I go down to QFan configuration, just what ASUS calls it. And there's cool things in here, to be honest, like QFan tuning will actually check all of your fans or as well as your pump, and it'll test its minimum and maximum speed, so it gives you a whole range. And finding out the minimum speed that a PWM device can run at is kind of useful. So definitely try out some of the utilities that are in your BIOS and see what you can come up with. I, however, don't have anything hooked up to the CPU fan header, so we ignore that. Everything's hooked up to just chassis fan headers, which work just the same. So now that we're into it, I had just have chassis fan 2, 3, and 4 populated with the two sets of three fans, Corsair LML120s, there's PWM fans, and the pump is on, I believe, header 3. Yes. So the pump is on channel 3, or chassis fan 3. This is my intake fans. No. Yes. I believe those are my intake fans. And these are the exhaust. Yes. So I have them all split up like that. Like I said, I have the intake fans on one set and the exhaust fans on another. And as far as setting up curves, I base all of mine off of a T sensor, which is just a temperature sensor, and it's a G and a quarter plug temperature sensor that I have just screwed into my pump top, which is one way you can read your coolant. You can add in like a T fitting with a temp sensor, and that'll also get you a reading for your coolant, which is something I definitely highly recommend to anybody that's liquid cooling and want to set up some fan curves with a stable temperature, because your coolant is what everything is going to be affected by. Obviously, it's a liquid cooling loop. So if you can get one of those, get a temperature sensor in there. Otherwise, you can go off your hardware, obviously, your CPU motherboard, whatever your motherboard supports, you can have it monitor off of that. Typically, you'll use CPU if you don't have like a temperature sensor of some sort. But another way to also help smooth out the curves is using step up and step down settings. I usually like to set them just a little bit.
with the water, it really kind of already helps the step up and step down. However, when you're just sitting there fluctuating, say between, you know, 29 and 30 degrees Celsius, your fans are going to sit there and fluctuate because of the temperature. So to avoid that, I put a little bit of a step up and step down on them. And then further down, I select manual mode to control them. I don't really like any of the preset options. So as far as, like I said, these are the intake fans, and I can scroll down and compare them to the exhaust fans, but these are running slightly faster than my exhaust fans. So I do have positive pressure. Like I was saying in the beginning, it's just an easy way to do it. It's based off the coolant temperature, so it goes from 30 to 36, and it'll range the speed from 40 to 80%. The reason why I only got 80 is because the fans get really fast, and they do get pretty loud. Right now, idling, you shouldn't even be able to hear it, not much at least, and that's how I kind of have it set up. So during idle, and like when I don't have headphones on, or I'm not gaming or working on something, it's nearly completely silent. But under load, obviously things will get a little bit louder, but like if I'm gaming, I have headphones on, so it doesn't make as big of a difference. So moving on, the pump I have set from 60 to 100. I've found that, at least with my loop, with the higher restriction, I have two rads and a CPU block, or a mono block, a RAM block, and a GPU block. So the restriction kind of gets up there a little bit. So to kind of help with that, I keep my pump running a little bit faster. Your system may be different as far as your pump config goes, but I would definitely suggest messing around with your pump speed and at least running a few benchmarks at different speeds and seeing what kind of temperatures you get with your different flow rate. You can also get flow rate meters, just like a temp sensor, which is another way to measure it. But anyways, you definitely want to keep track of your pump speed if you do have a PWM model. If you're Vario, obviously you're going to set it, and if it works, it works. If it doesn't, then you turn it up. And this is just my exhaust fans. As I was saying, these are set a little bit slower, so they go from 30 to 70%. So they're always a good 10% slower than the intake fans, which should indeed give me positive pressure. And as far as I can tell, it does, no matter what, you get dust in your system. But positive pressure is nice. And overall, that's just the way I found that works really well for setting it up. Play around with all these numbers. I've messed around with it with my overclock as well, and just seeing what speeds do what. If you guys have any questions, like I've been saying, hit me up. I'm happy to answer them.
As I was saying in the beginning, this is just the method that I've found that works best for me, at least. Like I said, it seems to be reliable and consistent. So if you guys, you know, use a different method, feel free to share and let other people know. It's always fun to see what people make work for them and different ways you can achieve, you know, the same kind of performance and whatnot. So definitely stop by all of our social media sites, as I mentioned earlier. We got our Facebook group, which we've been doing weekly live streams in just an hour or so here. I'm going to be testing some Mayhem's dies on stream. So if you guys don't make it to that stream, you can count on seeing it on YouTube at some point here. So we'll get that uploaded as well. But definitely stop by our group, stop by our Discord, hang out, enjoy the content, ask questions. We're all here to help. So please feel free and join in the community. Other than that, though, everybody, I hope you all have a great day, and happy modding. Thank you.